Good morning, and welcome to the Village of Romeoville's Memorial Day service. I especially want to thank such a large crowd for coming out today with these weather conditions, but we have not failed to have one of these yet, and we will not today. And, you know, it really is heartwarming to see so many people out because this is an important day. And you're all like family to all of us. And I know that each in your own way, this is a special day of reflection. So I'm glad you're here to join us and be a part of this. Also with us today, I have a few dignitaries I want to introduce as we move along the program today. And with from the Village Board, I want to introduce some of our trustees. We have with us today Trustee Joe Chavez, Trustee Dave Richards, Trustee Ken Griffin, Trustee Linda Palmiter. Good. And we also have with us today our Village Clerk, Bernice Holloway. Did I get Dave? Good. Brian. Oh, there's Brian. And Trustee Brian Clancy. We're a little wet here today. You're hiding. We won't say anything about Trustee Javez blocking you. A little levity with the rain. Also, we have a few other dignitaries, and we're very fortunate to have them here today as well. And we have our State Senator, Jennifer Bertino Tarrant, joining us from the Will County Board is one of Romeoville's two Will County Board members, Don Moran. And also from DuPage Township, we have our tax collector, Patty Holloway. The DuPage Township clerk, Trish Stack. And DuPage Township trustee, Ken Burgess. And also, State Senator Pat McGuire had sent his regrets and a letter, which we're going to not read off completely today, but he did want to let everybody know how important this day is to him. He's tied up a little bit today, and he's been on here many times with us, so we appreciate his thoughts and his being a part of our program in the past. With that, I am now going to have, if you would rise with me, the Romeoville High School Marine Junior ROTC will be posting the colors. Now I'm going to call Deacon Jerry Clark up for the opening prayer. Deacon Jerry is with St. Andrew the Apostle Church.
Dear Heavenly Father, as we remember those who have made the ultimate sacrifice for the freedoms we enjoy every day, we think how they have followed in the footsteps of your Son, our Lord. Please hold our servicemen and women in your strong arms. Cover them with your sheltering grace and your presence as they stand in the gap for our protection. We also remember the families of our troops. We ask for your unique blessings to fill their home, and we pray for peace and provision and strength will fill their lives. May the members of our armed forces be supplied with courage to face each day, and may they trust in the Lord's mighty power to accomplish each task. And let our military brothers and sisters feel our love and support. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen.
Please be seated. Now I'm going to bring up our guest speaker for today, and that is Charles Lynn Lauder. If you would join us, and we're very happy to have you join us today.
First of all, thank you for coming out today. It's entirely befitting that we have a rainy, overcast day to say thank you to the generation upon generation of young men and women who stand in the gap year after year. And those people, ladies and gentlemen, are what keep the wolf away from the door, plain and simple. Without them, this country wouldn't exist. Without our military people standing strong, we wouldn't be here. So this country is the light of the world. There's never been a country like it. Not in the history of known mankind, and nothing this good is going to be given or it's going to come easy. This country was born in war, It has had to fight for its existence, and it's had to stand and fight for people who wanted to be independent. And ladies and gentlemen, we're at war now. And there are people that do not believe in our way of life and what we stand for. So thank you. This is the best part of America right here. I was raised in a small town in downstate Illinois, and I know who I'm talking to here. So thank you for standing strong. To my brothers and sisters that served, God bless each and every one of you. Thanks for stepping forward. To the wives and the families that have stood with them and still stand with them, thank you for doing that. For this community, for showing up and letting veterans know you care, thank you. It is said that the way you dishonor a warrior is you deny them the dignity of their experience. Now, I'm a Vietnam veteran. We kind of feel we've got overwatch on these men and women that are serving since 9/11. We don't want to go back and ever confuse the warrior with the conflict. We want to support those people that are standing with us. We've got a bit of a challenge now, and I'm going to tell you straight up about this. We've been at war now for, 13 years? There are people that have served one tour, two tours, three tours, four tours, five tours in combat. The 10th Mountain Division, a couple years ago, there were people in there that had served seven combat tours. So right now, as we stand here, there are people that are probably in rain, probably in heat, and probably ducking bullets so that this country can go forward. Now, we have got 1 million veterans unemployed. We've got another 1 million coming off active duty in the next 4 to 5 years. And we have 22 suicides every single day. And this has been going on, ladies and gentlemen, for weeks and months and months. Now, it kind of comes down to this. If a person can't feed themselves, if they can't put food on the table, they can't pay the rent, the world can be a pretty dark place. And I believe, I'm no psychologist, I'm no mental health professional, but I believe that the last thing that happens before a person takes that unfortunate fatal step is the last flicker of hope goes out. And then the world can become a very dark place. Less than 0.5% of our people serve today. So it's a lot easier for these veterans to fall into the cracks, frankly. So I want to tell you what does work. I stood up a program at the University of Central Missouri about 4 years ago. I was asked to come out there and help them do this. So I went out there, and I had a chance to work with a great number of these fine young men and women, these recent veterans of the 9/11 conflict ongoing. And it dusted off my old Vietnam brain and took me back in time. And what these young men and women are doing is what veterans have always been doing coming back from warfare. They're trying to find their lane in life. What am I going to do now that's going to add meaning and value to my life, purpose? Who am I and what am I going to do? In the time that I was there, we built a program from about 400 veterans to over 1,400. And people would come in all the time with different programs that they might have they would want to expose our veterans to. But I'll tell you what worked and what worked best. What worked best was one-on-one human interaction. I would have veterans that would come in there. We had quite a few veterans on staff, quite a few veterans that taught there. And they would come in and they would say, Lynn, I've got some time. I'd like to help. What can I do? And I would say to him something like, you see that young man over there with that blue ball cap on? Would you please go over there and introduce yourself? Would you maybe take him down for a cup of coffee? Would you befriend them? Would you come alongside them? Would you treat them like a son or a daughter? Would you love them and would you stick with them and would you help them find their path in life? And then I want you to help them help network them and get them a job. These people need three things: a roof over their head, food on the table, and a shot at a decent job. Not a freebie. All they want is a chance to compete. Now, we're moving here in the state of Illinois and the organization I'm with to help veterans get into business. When they come out of the military now, there are three paths that are offered to them. Go to college, get a job. That's door number one. Door number two, get a trade, get a job. Door number three, go start in business for yourself. And that's where the conversation falls flat, falls silent. Because there is no path, especially for the junior enlisted personnel, to get enough capital, collateral, to finance a business loan. You should know that in the 9 years following World War II, 50% of our veterans went into business for themselves. We've got to build back our small business economy, and veterans deserve a shot as much as anybody else. And so we're looking to make that happen here in the state of Illinois and federally. I want to tell you there's a lady here amongst us that is an absolute bulldog in this regard, and Senator Jennifer Bertino Tarrant over my shoulder here. This lady here is a bulldog. She is serving your interests well, and she is leading the fight here in Illinois to make this a reality. So, Senator, thank you very much, and God bless you. Thanks for listening to me. Thanks for standing for our veterans. Thanks for this wonderful day and allowing me to be amongst you. God bless America. God bless you. The fight goes on. Thank you.
Thank you. And now we will have the presentation of the wreaths. Our first organization today that will make a presentation will be the American Legion Post 52. Next will be the American Legion Auxiliary, Unit 52. CPAR will be presenting the next wreath. Thank you. Next will be the Grand Haven Veterans Club. The next wreath presentation is from the Hampton Park Social Athletic Club. Our next organization will be the Lions Club. The next wreath will be presented by the Romeoville Area Historical Society. Thank you. Next, we have the Romeoville Veterans Commission. And our final wreath will be presented by the Village of Romeoville. Now, if everyone would join me in a moment of silence, an observance of all past, present, and fallen men and women who have fought or are fighting for our country, please. Once again, I would like Deacon Jerry Clark to join us for a closing prayer.
Father, we thank you for all the marvelous things you have done today. Thank you for your love that you have revealed to us and for the love that we share together as your body. We pray for all the words that you have sown into people's hearts today. Watch over them and protect them. May they take root and produce wonderful things, things of beauty and great blessings to many. And as we leave this place now, we thank you that you walk with us. May we be alert to your promptings and live in your endless love. For yours is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Again, I want to thank you all for joining us here in Romeoville for Memorial Day service. You know, as I woke up this morning, and I rose to my 3-year-old, and he crawled in bed with my wife and I, And he rolls over and he says, "Daddy, you know what? I got a surprise for you. I love you." You know, on a morning like this, things like that make you appreciate the freedoms we've been given by the people who have passed away and served us. You know, together, we enjoy those freedoms. It gives us the right to succeed, to even fail, but to do it together. I'm proud to serve this community, and I'm proud to honor those who gave us a right to do that. You know, I also call my father every year, who's a disabled Vietnam vet, just spend a little time talking about the people that served with him and fell, and I know how important that is. So I ask each and every one of you once again, even today, but throughout the year, if you see somebody who served and they knew someone that, or a family member, please reach out to them. Let them know how much it means. Also, I'm struck today by Mr. Lauder's comments and his organization and his cause, but one vet at a time. And I pull a little audible here on the village board and our staff, and I'm going to personally commit to working with them, and I know they'll be there with me, and this community will be, the finding ways that we can help veterans, especially returning veterans, to start new businesses in our community, especially those that have come from our own communities as well. And so we'll look at that too. We've done a lot in this community to help our veterans and the families and those, and remember those who have been, that served us. But we can never stop, because our service to them is to continue to remember and look at ways that we can make our communities better and celebrate the gift they've been given us. So with that, I thank you again, and it is always an honor to serve all of you and be your friend. Thank you.
Okay.